Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Here in the Philippines, I just want to thank all you guys for your prayers. Those of you who are praying for Joshua's ministry, those of you who have donated to Joshua's ministry, those of you who have encouraged me through your messages and stuff, you know, some of you have even given me words from the Lord. I really do sincerely appreciate it. I thank all you guys. The prayers of a righteous person availeth much. That's a whole other video I need to make. Or maybe that's part of this one. You know, I always end up saying I'm going to do different videos. The Lord gives me lots of messages, and then I kind of just combine it. Sometimes, you know, I mean, it's obviously the way the Lord wants me to deal with it. Look at this. The Lord's talking to me about different things. I want to do some teachings about being a fervent, like it says in James, the fervent, righteous prayer of a man availeth much. James chapter 5, I believe it's verse 16. I want to talk about that, and I want to put a video link down here to one of the worship songs. That, you know, the Lord was just leading me to look at that, and that's a whole nother video. I will put the link under here. And let me just say this, that I just had a vision, you know, but I want to do this teaching. And the problem is, you know, that, like I always say, there's thousands of people that will watch a video about a vision of the rapture, and then only, you know, hundreds, which, I mean, you know, there's a lot less people who really want to hear some meat of the word. And that's the part. Here's the vision, is that, I downloaded these songs, some of them a year ago, some of them 2 years ago, some of them 3 years ago, from World Harvest Revival Church there in Kansas City, Missouri. It's been a revival that's been going on. Came out of the pastor went down to Brownsville, you know, was ready to quit the ministry, came back, was hit by the Holy Spirit way back. It's been 20 years, basically, I think. They started in a small town in Kansas and had to move to Kansas City. And, you know, I heard him interviewed 10 years ago, and I don't remember all the details. But anyway, I found some of their worship songs. They're all anointed, all great. And then I listen to them. When I'm doing prayer, I will play worship music. I play various worship music as the Lord leads me. You know, like warfare music, praise music, worship music. It depends on, you know, how the Lord is moving, you know. And that's the secret about worship music. Like Charles Wesley, the brother of John Wesley, he wrote the songs that went along with the Great Awakening in America. God has music that comes from heaven that matches the move of God of what he's doing. Just like I've told you guys before, if the Lord leads me to preach about healing, I would expect God to move with the anointing of healing and people to be healed. Signs and wonders to follow the word, the Bible teaches us. God confirms his word with signs and wonders. So you would also assume there will be worship music. If I'm singing worship music, praise music about overcoming the enemy, I would assume and that the Lord is leading that he's doing some kind of a, you know, intercession, breakthrough, spiritual warfare type of a thing. It's just common sense also, brothers and sisters. It sounds like, in a way, it's like a deep teaching and a revelation if you never heard it. But if you think about it, it's common sense. Everything with God is like that. It's simple enough for a child to understand, but yet so complicated, you know, that people get lost in it. Like a great example, of course, is the Gospel of John. The most simply worded book in the Bible. With the book of John, the Gospel of John, has the least amount of variation of words of any book in the New Testament. But yet, the deep meanings, like the word light, you know, and all of these words that are used in there, all these deep meanings, and that's a whole other teaching too. But anyway, I'm going to put that video link down here. And the Lord told me to watch the video, one of these videos. I'll put the link down here. And they're all about the same, you know. And I some of them I've never even seen before. I just listen to it, you know, the music. As I'm worshiping, I'm not looking. Lots of times when I go to denominational churches and they have guest singers, and I've even invited spirit-filled singers to come sing. When I went to those Baptist churches and did revivals, they're sitting there like it's a performance. They're like looking at the singer like they're at a concert. Instead of worshiping the Lord or praising the Lord, they're like, the people came there to entertain them and sing to them instead of sing as unto the Lord. It's for man. So lots of people when they're in church, so the religious people, these old Pharisees, they'll say, oh, I've heard it 100 times. I went to one of those Assemblies of God churches or whatever, and I saw people in there raising their hands and people would go into the altar during the singing. Oh, they're just trying to get attention. No. Number one, you need to stop looking at everybody else. I don't care what anybody else is doing. When I go to church, I'm trying to get a hold of the Lord. I'm trying to minister to the Lord. When you do praise and worship, we're ministering to the Lord. When you're here preaching, God's ministering to the people. God ministers to the people through those preaching, and we minister to God through the praise and worship. And I'm only focused on worship and praising the Lord. God, what do you want me to do? Lord, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to, go to the altar? Do you want me to pray for the people standing in front of me? Maybe somebody standing in front of me is not saved. You know, before I became, was working as a full-time pastor, I would stand in there and pray, Lord, the Lord would lead me to, intercede for this person up here. I did it 100 times. I've never talked about this. There's probably lots of you who are spirit-filled people. You've done this too. I begin to pray for a person that's, in front of me in the church that the Lord was leading me to pray. And I would pray and pray and pray. Next thing you know, the person is crying and then they go to the altar. God was using me to intercede for them. Someone asked me the difference between interceding and mediating. There's only one mediator between God and man. That's the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible tells us. But to intercede, Mary doesn't intercede for us. We intercede for each other. Christians can intercede for each other. And fervently. And that's the problem with these religious people. The real problem with people that don't want to speak in tongues and talk junk about speaking in tongues and keep blaspheming it and running it down is because they don't want to be embarrassed. And if I prayed and asked God before, God, Lord, why did you? Because I don't usually call God God. I'm just using that generically on here. But I don't like to use that word. But I said, Lord, I used to say Father. I used our Heavenly Father. You're talking about the Father. I said, Lord, why is, tongues? Because so many people have a problem with it. It's just like the opposite of what I would think in my natural mind because it seems to stumble so many people. And then the Lord just told me and showed me and said, look, Jesus, the gospel, Jesus said, I am a stumbling block. The Lord is a stumbling block. And His gospel is a stumbling block to people. And tongues is a physical manifestation, a literal stumbling block for people. That's why they keep talking junk about it and all that. Because they're worried about what other people's going to think about them, what other people's going to do, what other people's going to say. That's what they're worried about. They can't surrender. They can't let go. You're going to watch this video I put down here from World Harvest Revival Church. And all them old Pharisees will maybe there. Oh, those people are fake and talking junk, whatever. No, those people are fervently, righteously praying and interceding for America, interceding for the city they live in, Kansas City, interceding for the body of Christ, interceding for the lost, worshiping God. They're fervently praying. That's what this is. Look at this video. And like I said, I don't watch what other people's doing, but the Lord led me. He wants you to watch this. And you know what the Lord, I had a vision and a word from the Lord from watching this video. And here's, I had a rapture vision. That's the headline. So all of you shallow into the pool people can watch this video. While I was watching it, the Lord told me, because I've been praying, and told me to watch this video. I've never even really watched the video before. I've glanced at it, never watched it. I saw those people there being raptured, and in that audience, there was a few people left behind who were fakers in the audience. Less than 10% of the people in the audience who appeared to be fervently worshiping God were left behind. But 90% of those people, which the Lord is leading in me, in my heart, that it's way more than most churches. Way. In most churches, it's the other way around. 10%, God's tithe will be raptured, and the 90% are tares in most churches. This church was the opposite. A church that's in revival is the opposite. It has a tithe of tares and 90% children of God. And then your average church has, your regular church, your dead religion, your dead in Christ, those who will rise first is 10%. So it's a joke. The 10%. The tithe in the church is really the Lord's children. So, and then the Lord spoke a word to me. By the end of the song, the song's about 5 or 6 minutes long. At the end of the song, the Lord spoke a word to me. And he spoke like what he said when Jesus got baptized. He said, these are my children, and in them am I well pleased. In them am I well pleased. And then I saw the Lord as if he was telling the angels to be quiet. The Lord was like this, for everything to be silent in heaven. And he was listening. And the Lord was well pleased with what he saw and what he heard on this video. Now, all of you who want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit and haven't received the Holy Spirit, all of you who want to get closer to God, the people I prayed with in Seattle, Texas, some in Louisiana, some already got close to God. Praise the Lord. All the places I went, people trying to get closer to God, to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, seek and ye shall find, Jesus said, knock and it'll be opened to you, ask and you shall receive. God says, draw close to me and I'll draw close to you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. Jeremiah 33:3. Or call upon me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. Jeremiah 33:3. Another verse from Jeremiah says, draw close to me and I'll draw close to you. Brothers and sisters, this video is well-pleasing to the Lord. This is His children. They're well-pleasing to Him. If you want to know about going in the rapture, will you go in the rapture? This is the natural manifestation of the fruit of the children of God. And the Lord gave me a verse last night where John the Baptist, the people asked John the Baptist, what should we do? And he said, bear fruit in keeping with repentance. Bear fruit in keeping with repentance. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And that's what my second video is going to be about. The Lord's been dropping all these prophecy bombs on me from 2 Thessalonians. The Lord gave me a Bible verse. I opened it up. Boom. I was right there at it like He did the other day. It's new for me. The Lord gave me Esther. I opened up Esther. Boom, boom, boom. The Lord is unsealing the book of Esther to me by His grace, by His love, by His favor for Joshua's ministry, that people will hear this word. It's another video. I'm going to cut this off, which I normally don't do. And I'm going to make a second video about Esther. Hold on, hold the phone. Next video.